In lecture 15, we will discuss the K-map simplification by using four variables. Okay. From lecture 13 to 16, actually we will discuss the K-map simplification. In lecture 13, we already discussed the two variable. In 14, three variable. Now we will discuss the four variable simplification using K-map. Okay. If you are using a four variable K-map, there will be 2^4 means 16 combinations will be there. So 16 min terms you need to represent. So this is the general structure of the four variable K-map. It contains 16 cells because 16 min terms we need to represent. Okay, 16 min terms we need to represent. That's why we are using 16 cell. So if A, B, C, D are the variable, two variable will represent row wise and two variable in column wise. So A, B can be represented 0, 0. Four combinations will be there, 0, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 0, and then we will write 1, 1, because we are not using binary format. We already discussed in previous lecture that this is a binary sequence, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. But in K-map, we are using gray code, okay? Not binary sequence. So this is a binary sequence, but we are using gray code in sequence in K-map. So in column wise also 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, then 1, 1. Okay, there is only single bit change in row wise or column wise. So for that we are using gray code. And if you write the min terms, closely observe how to write the min term. This is very important in K-map, in four variable K-map. So this first term is min term 0. This is 1, and this is 2, and then we'll write 3. Okay, and 4, 5, and instead of writing 6 here, the last we'll write 6, then 6, 7, and the 8 we'll write here, 8, 9, 10 here, 11, 12, 13, 14, and finally 15. So this is the flow how we'll write this binary sequence. So you can cross-check this. For example, the first term is 0, 0, 0, 0, that is 0. And when you write the third column value, then 0, 0 here, row-wise, column-wise, 1, 1, which is equal to 3. Okay, that's why we are writing 0, 1, 2, 3, and 0, 0, 1, 0 here. And similarly, if you look at 15, this is 1, 1, and column-wise, 1, 1. So this is a 15. And this is also indicating the min term representation of each cell. And now we'll try this problem. In this particular question, you can see that min terms are given because this is sigma is also required. Okay, this is SOP expression. So SOP expression, sigma is required, and it's actually four variable. So W, X, I can represent here, Y, Z here. And the reverse also you can represent, but at that time you need to take care of how to write these values. So now it is 0, 0, four combinations will be available for W and X, 1, 1, and 1, 0. Here it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and finally 1, 1. Okay, and the variable representing that W bar X bar, W bar X, W, X, W X bar. In column wise it's Y is Z bar, Y bar is Z bar, Y bar is Z, Y is Z, and Y is Z bar. Now corresponding min term 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 you will write here, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, instead of writing 14 here, we'll write 14 here, and 15. So this is a format of K-map for variable K-map. Now we need to indicate these values in the K-map. And we need to indicate 4, 5 will mark it as 1. 10 we need to represent. And 11 we need to represent. 14 we need to represent. And 15 we need to represent. The other values we will put it as 0. Okay. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now we need to group it. We need to check as a 16 group is possible, or 8, or 4, 2, 1. In this way, we need to write. So there is no 16 ones. So we need to write 8, group is possible? No. Then now we can group it as four ones. So this is a 4-1 group, and we can write the binary equivalent of this particular, sorry, not binary, the Boolean expression representing this particular group. In row wise, if you look at this is 1-1 and 1-0, third and fourth, here 1 is common. So W you can use to represent this row value, and column you can say 1-1, 1-0, again 1 is common, that is Y actually. So WY to represent this. And now we can group these two ones. So to represent these, this particular group, in row wise it is W bar X is common. In column wise you can say 0 is common, means Y bar. So the final expression for F we can write WY plus W X bar Y bar. Okay, W X bar Y bar. So this is the final simplified expression for this particular function. Now we'll move to the next. Okay, we got exactly same. Now again, here the variables are represented by the letters A, B, C, D. So again, four variable. So we need to write different combination of C, D, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay, you need to look at this sequence change. This is 0, 0. 0 1, and finally we'll write 1 0, then 1 1. Then the variable representing that c bar d bar c d c d c d bar, and here it is a bar b and a b here, and a b bar. Okay. Now the minterms corresponds to this 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14, and finally 15. So now we need to represent this values. Okay, 0 we need to represent 1 and 2 minterm 1, now we need to represent 4, then 5, then 6 we need to represent, then 8 is here, then 9 we need to represent, then 12 we need to represent, 13 we need to represent, and finally 14 we need to represent. So I think I indicated all values. So let me check whether I completed. I got all the values. Now I need to group the sequence. So in order to group the sequence, I need to check whether it's a 16 group, 8, 4, 2, 1. So 16, there is no 16 ones. So now we can group 8 ones. So here you can see that 8 ones are there. So I can consider this group. So if you represent this particular group, in row wise, there is no common time. But in column wise, there is a common time, that is 0 is common for both column 1 and 2. So I can indicate C bar. Okay. Now you need to think about the 2, 6, 14 minterms. So if you consider this, I can group in as a group 4 like this. I can consider 2, 6 and 0, 4 as a single term, a single group, as a group of 4. Okay. 1, 2 row and 1, 4 column. Okay. So in order to represent this particular group, 4, 1 group, then row wise it's 0 0 0 1, so A is common, so I can write A bar. Okay, not reference 0, we are using A bar. Now first and last column, again you look at this, 0 is common for first and last column, so here it is D bar. So I can represent this by using another Boolean expression. Now we can see there is one more one here. Again, I need to make it a group of 1, 2. Again, I can make a group of 4 here like this. Okay, 6, 14 and this 4 term. So I'll get another group. So in order to represent this, here you can see that B is common for both second and third row. So I can write B here. And for the first and last column, I think D bar is common, so we can write like this. So the final expression will be like this: C bar plus A bar D bar, then B D bar. So this is the final simplified form of this particular expression. Now you can see that in this particular question, the expression is given in a SOP form, but I need to simplify. So variables are W, X, Y, Z. So I can write 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. In terms of variable W bar, Z bar, Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z bar. In terms of W and X, W bar, X bar, W bar, X, W, X, W, X bar. And in terms of minterm, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, finally 15. So to write this sequence, first we need to say W bar X bar. So W bar X bar is here and Y bar is Z bar. So Y bar, so I need to indicate the first cell. And then W bar X bar. So again, first row, Y bar is it. Y bar is it mean second column. So I need to indicate one. In this way, you can fill this K map. But instead of write, I will use another method. So I can write the binary equivalent here. So it's 0, 0, 0, 0. Here it is 0, 0, 0, 1. Here it is 0, 0, 1, 0. Here it is 0, 1, 1, 0. 1, 0, 0, 0. And 1, 0, 0, 1. And 1010. I can write the min times corresponds to this. This is 0, and this is 1, and this is 2, and this is 6, and this is 8, and this is 9, and this is 10. So I can indicate this value. So I already indicated 0 here, 1. Now I need to write 2. Now 6 is required, so I can indicate 6. Then 8 I need to indicate. Then 9 I need to indicate. Then 10 I need to indicate. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 values. 6, 7 values. The other values I can put as 0. Okay. Otherwise, function will give you 0. Now, I need to group this. So, in order to group this particular sequence, I will first consider, okay, there is one here. Okay. And at the corner, another one is there. And at the corner, another one is there. And 10. So this is another trick that we can use in K-map. At the corners, you can fold. So, and you can make a group of four. So if there is one like this, I can make a group of four. So if you consider this particular group, okay, I can represent this first and last row. The common term for the first and last is X bar. So I can write X bar. In column wise, the first and last column, the common term is Z bar. So I can write Z bar. Okay. Now I can see that 2 ones here, 2 ones at the end. So again, a group of four. To represent this particular group, again, first and last row, you can write X bar, and column first and second, the common term is Y bar. So I can write X bar, Y bar. Now we can see that there's a one, and now we can make a group of two. So then row wise, the common term is W bar, and column wise, it's Y Z bar. So I can conclude the final result. X bar Z bar plus X bar Y bar plus W bar Y Z bar. This is the final simplified expression for this particular question. Okay. Now I will check another question. Okay. We got this. And now we need to simplify this particular expression. I'll directly go to the value. So this is a K map. Okay. If you write, I'll draw this. So we need a 16 cell. So A, B, C, D. So A, B, C, D values will be there. Then I'll row 16 cells. Then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Sorry, 1, 1, 1, 0. And in column wise, sorry, column wise 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. Now we need to indicate the ones and zeros in this particular box. We need to represent 0, 1 you need to represent, 3 you need to represent, 5 you need to represent, 7 you need to represent, 8 you need to represent, 9 you need to represent, 11, 13, and 50. Okay. Now the other values are 0. Now we need to group this. So in order to group this, you can see that a group of 8 I can consider. Now in order to represent this group, row wise there is no common term. Column wise, if you look, there is one is common for both column 2 and 3. So we can write D to corresponding to that. And in there is another one here, the last first row also, so I can make a group of 4 here, these two ones and these two, so edges I can fold, so I'll get a group of 4. So to represent that, the first and last row the common term is 0, so which corresponds to B bar actually. And in column wise, first and second column again 0 is common, so I can write C bar. So the final simplified expression for this particular question is D plus B bar C bar. Okay. If you look at this particular diagram, there's a small difference. Okay. I'll tell you that in some textbook, they will write AB here, CD here. Now in our representation, AB in row wise, CD in column wise. So that is the difference in this particular figure. So both way you can approach. But when you write in this way, the midterms are different. So when you look at any other textbooks, you need to cross-check this. Okay, whether you are writing the first two variables in row wise, second column. So here, the first two variables are written in column wise, and then there must be values are written in row wise. So the final answer will be same, but the midterms ordering will be different. Okay, so you can study any one method, but make sure that you are comfortable with the when you change the variable. Okay. So now I'll give you another question. Here is 0, 1, 4, 5, 8, 9, 13, 15 using K-map. Okay, when you solve this particular question, you can, after simplification, you will get like this. So there will be one group, 1, 1, and the last 1, 1. So to represent this, I can write the value. So the first and the last row, the common term is B bar, and for the first and second column, the common term is D bar. Sorry, just A bar, and for the second and first and second, it's D bar. Okay, and then if you write this particular group, the first and it's A bar B bar, A bar B actually, this A B A B bar, here it is C bar, here also some mistake, it's C bar D actually. Okay, and okay, remaining is C. So if you write this particular expression, the first one will be, the common term is B bar here, and this first and second column common term is C bar. Okay, now it is correct. Okay, these two values are, need to verify change. It is A bar B. Okay. Now, corresponds to this particular circle, the common term is A bar in row wise and column wise C bar. Now, if you consider this particular group, okay, it's AB common in row wise, column wise it's D. So you can write ABD. So this is a function. But you can see that there is another group we can form by group of four. But already all the ones are considered. So we will not consider this particular group. Okay. So this particular group we can call it as a redundant group. So we don't want to consider that because all ones are already considered in another group. So we will not consider this particular group. So similarly, we'll consider another question where there is a redundant group. See, in this particular question also, after grouping all the terms, okay, here you can see a dotted circle at the center. So group of four. But even if it is in group of four, in order to represent the other values, we need to consider the small groups. Okay. So the after considering the, all the ones, the center group will be redundant. So we don't want to consider this central group. Okay. This is another example. Next lecture, we will discuss the Doncare conditions and non-standard SOP form, how we can solve this non-standard SOP form.